Are you looking to replace the gas motor on your dinghy with a modern, clean, quiet, electric motor? Before you wander all around the internet looking for that perfect electric outboard, join me at the Seattle Boat Show, where we meet up with Joe Grez of EP Carry to see his light, powerful, and award-winning ship-to-shore electric motor.
Well, Bruno Hoffman with the Green Boater TV. We are so happy today to be at the Seattle Boat Show, and we're meeting Joe with EP Carry. Joe, tell me a little bit about your backstory. So years ago, I was a boater, and the state actually got me on this road. The state, with my boater registration, sent a sticker that said carbon monoxide warning danger. And I'd just been doing research on carbon monoxide warning dangers, and found that smaller body mass sizes are more susceptible to it than larger. We had a three-year-old at home. And so I decided I would never take her out on a gas-powered boat again, and converted my boat to electric right on the spot. So that season, we ended up using the boat a lot more, right? It was quieter, it was it didn't stall, didn't have to start it. It had instant reverse. Maneuvering was better. We could have conversations while we were going. It was wonderful. And at that point, being a product developer, I thought, well, how can I, you know, share this with others? You know, what's the best way to do that? So it took about a year for me to figure out the concept of making portable motors and trying to attack a segment that no one's ever addressed before.
And this wasn't just backyard stuff. You were actually, this is your background. You've been designing these similar type of engineering concepts in the past.
Yeah, I've been developing consumer products, notably Sonicare toothbrushes, Clarisonic face brushes, things like that.
Yeah. So you were knowledgeable in this area. It wasn't just something you thought of in your mind.
Yeah, and I had access to people that were very very helpful, let's say, along the way.
Yeah, wonderful. And how long ago was that we started?
It was about 9 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah.
So the journey came directly to this product, or did you have some versions to it?
It did have some versions. So we started out with an approximation. You know, we took a guess at what would be the right product for the ship-to-shore, you know, portable segment. We hit the mark, but we over-delivered on some things and under-delivered on other things. So we regrouped, and then a year and a half ago, we launched this new product, and it's doing super well.
Wonderful. Tell us about the product. So the range, the product, the price points?
Well, there are a lot of electric motors out there, right? And so we didn't want to just make a copy of someone's electric motor. As it turns out, most electric motors that are out there are copies of gas motors. They're just electric, right?
Really?
So we went and took the use case behind a particular segment, which is ship to shore, dinghy use, and took it all apart, figured out how much power was needed, what the charging requirements would be, what speeds are expected, features like beaching, you know, all these kinds of things, and put it into a completely new concept. So, and that's what we have here. Now we have a product that has allows you to sit in the middle of the boat. Well, it's a small boat, right? So you have to balance it fore and aft, right? So now you can do that because it has a long tiller arm. All the controls are in the tip of the tiller arm, including lifting and lowering the motor. So you don't have to reach back for anything, right?
Nice.
It's very safe. It's very quiet. It runs for 2 or 3 days of ship to shore if you have a dog and a daughter like ours who likes to go fishing and crabbing. And then recharging, it's so efficient that it's not a draw on your house bank.
Yes.
So we charge from just a little tiny house bank aboard our small camp cruising sailboat.
And I guess that's always the perception. I mean, years ago, electric motors, when it was on land with cars, was sort of an eccentric kind of thing. But now we're seeing a big shift in the consumer acceptance of electric power on land.
Exactly.
Do you see that shift now happening in the marine industry?
It's totally. So there's a couple of us that are taking this kind of approach, you know, soup to nuts, you know, kind of a new concept approach. The idea is, and you see it in some of the car brands now, electric cars used to be a partial solution, right? You needed another car. Now there are cars that you can get that are 100% solution, right? Now we have consumer products for the marine industry that are also a 100% solution. It's not a hobbyist thing anymore. Anybody can run this motor.
Tell me about the battery as well, because that's always concerned with power.
So the battery is a very important part of the system, obviously, right? And that's, everybody knows that batteries are kind of holding back the whole industry as a general because of the cost of storage of energy in batteries, right? So the trick in this case is to choose a vendor for battery technologies that can produce something that's safe and consumer ready, something that a consumer can't break, right? And that's what we've found. We have a supplier that's giving us batteries that they supply batteries to the Navy.
Okay,
so they know what they're doing. So you can't overcharge them, you can't over discharge them. They won't run if you put them in too hot of a compartment, right? They're completely safe.
So that's one aspect of it. The other one is the range, and the way that you make a battery give you the range that's appropriate for your application is through efficiency.
Yes.
That's why efficiency is important, right? It's not just a bullet on a box, right?
Yeah, yeah.
If you make something that's 10 times more efficient than the standard that's out there, right, then you're gonna be able to go 10 times the range on the same battery.
Yes,
right?
Absolutely.
So there's a lot of finesse.
So like I said earlier, I think there is going to be a shift, you know, seeing what Tesla has done.
Yeah.
You know, it's not just now for the eccentrics, it's now mainstream.
So we're not alone, right? I would say most of the people here at the show are very interested in electric powering.
Yeah.
And that's why they have an electric boat showcase here at the show this year.
Yes.
Problem is, people aren't going to shift until there's an advantage to them to shift, right? And that's human nature, it's the way it is. So those manufacturers that figure out how to make sure that the solution meets all the needs of the consumer and it's at a reasonable price, those are the manufacturers that are going to be leaders in this shift. Everybody wants the shift, right? But you have to also have a high quality product that meets all the needs before people will shift to it.
Where can people go to find information about your product?
So we have a recently updated website. It's very informative. It's epcarry.com, and that's the best way to get in touch with us. There's telephone numbers on there. You can call up and talk to us. You're not talking to somebody who doesn't know the product. You're talking to us.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Yeah.
Joe, thank you so much for your time, and this is just a fantastic product. Thank you for your passion.
You
moved from toothbrushes to boats.
Yep.
That's been fantastic. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's Green Boater at the Seattle Boat Show with EP Carry, and it's been wonderful just to learn a little bit more about this alternative to powering your boat, and look forward to many more things coming out of your group.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks.
Hey, I trust you enjoyed today's episode of the Green Boater TV. If you'd like to learn more about what it means to be a green boater as an ocean enthusiast, learn about products, practices, hear from people with experience, I encourage you to subscribe by hitting the button below. Hey, until next time, this is the Green Boater, looking for ways to help you create the ocean you love.